This straight line here is what I call harmony or balance. In music, harmony is when all sounds come together in unison to make what the brain recognizes as beautiful music. In food, harmony is when ingredients come together to make what the brain recognizes as good taste. So it's the bringing together of things in balance. Malcolm Gladwell wrote a small article in Ketchup and said ketchup is the one food in which all ingredients come together in perfect harmony, so much so the brain can't pull apart the ingredients, right? So it's harmony. The entire sensory line of products we sell is based on this harmony. So, part of my drawing, I'm not an artist, but 2,500 years ago, Aristotle defined the five basic senses as sight, hearing, ear, smell, taste, and touch. Over time, we've obviously learned, we have science, we've progressed, and we recognize that there are eight basic senses. So what we've added to that are proprioception, vestibulation, and vibration. In and of itself, vestibulation and vibration are a conversation that is a whole other training. But today with weighted blankets, we can focus a little bit more on proprioception. So as human beings, our brains are constantly seeking balance in everything and every action we do. If we're driving and we hear an ambulance, our hearing spikes, and the brain constantly looks around to find the source of that sound to pull itself back into balance. So in terms of balance, people can be one of three things. You're constantly looking for balance, so you're in a balanced state. If you're hyperactive, that's what I call the A's, and that's when you're very above balance. So this is going to be your hyper. I call it the A's because from a sales perspective, that's typically your people who are experiencing autism, Asperger's, anxiety, attention deficit, Alzheimer's. So I kind of remember hyperactive is the A's, and as an umbrella, those illnesses and issues that are A-related. If you are understimulated, you're what's called hypo. I'm no artist, I apologize. And I always remember those by the letter S. So when you're understimulated, it's S, that's your sleepy. Those are your seniors. Those are your sensory deprivation. Down syndrome, a lot of your syndromes tend to be hypoactive. In terms of selling sensory products, we constantly want to look at, or my role is to look at the client base our clients are serving, and are they hypo or hyper, to identify what products are best for them. So how do weighted blankets play into this? As an example of someone with autism, so I'm just going to say autism, typically autism, people under autism spectrum disorder, hyper-hyper-stimulated with vision, hyper-hyper-stimulated with auditory, tend to be a little lower or around medium ground with olfactory. Taste, that's a little bit more personal, tends to be a bit lower. Touch, definitely lower to none. Proprioception, definitely lower to none. So when you look at someone with autism, there's no way on a regular plane that they're in balance. So what we need to do is find one product that can bring the hyper down to balance, bring the sound down to balance, and bring these other things up to balance. And it's when you find that balance that that student can then perform at school. It's one that adult can then function in the day program. And it's when their brain is most receptive to stimulation. Proprioception is the next sense, and this is where weighted blankets come in. Basically, we have the sensation of touch. And touch is typically defined as when we reach out and touch something. Proprioception is the effect of pressure and feeling on our body and on our skin. So the skin is the largest organ in our body, and it contains us. Without our skin, we're a puddle on the floor. By virtue of that, it's the most receptive of all of our organs. Typically, nothing touches our heart or our other organs. Some of you maybe agitated by the tag on the back of your clothing. Some of you cut that off, some of you it doesn't bother you. If that tag on the back of your clothing bothers you, you are hyper in that element of proprioception.
If it doesn't bother you, you're probably balanced or hypo. Okay, so my example, in the middle of summer when it's 30 degrees at night and I go to bed and it's hot, I still have to have a blanket or a sheet. Some people maybe do, maybe don't. For me, my brain can't send a message to my proprioceptive system that says you're okay to go to sleep, you can relax, unless I have stimulation on my body, and that could be as light as a sheet. This lends itself to weighted blankets. So for me, I'm going to bed at night, my brain says, do you see anything? That sensory system says, nope, it's dark, check, you can go to sleep. The brain says, do you hear anything? I say, nope, it's quiet, check, you can go to sleep. Do you smell anything? No. Are you eating anything? No. Are you touching anything? I am not reaching out to touch anything. So if it was just these five systems, the brain can then say, you're in perfect balance to go to sleep. Off I go. When it comes to proprioception, if I have nothing, if I'm just laying on my bed, the brain's going to say, is your organ of skin stimulated to the fact where you can shut down and go to sleep? For me, it's going to go, no, I need more stimulation, so I blanket. Proprioception is often confused with temperature, and we see this a lot in kids. So in work with schools, I'll do, you will see children in winter, best intention, we bundle our kids up and send them off to school. They get to school. If you have a child with autism who is hypersensitive, and he is then wearing a big heavy sweater, and big heavy socks, and jeans to stay warm, that is going to shoot him further through the roof. Typically what I'll say to parents is, send your child to school dressed warm, but then let him run around in a tank top in class. It's not about temperature. It's about him having too much stimulation. So we gotta change that. Getting to the weighted blankets. This is where weighted blankets, to me, are the puzzle piece that puts it all together. So this system is all over our body. It does two things when it's stimulated. It creates what I call the tonin sisters. They're going to be serotonin or melatonin. When you have deep pressure on your body or pressure on your organs, if you are hyperactive, it creates melatonin in your body, which immediately slows you down. If you are under or hypoactive, it creates serotonin in your body, deep pressure, which immediately brings your level of alertness up. It is the one product that self-regulates in a blanket. No mechanical pieces. It's all natural and it's deep pressure. So the reason why I wanted to do this little training is to understand a couple things about the blankets, because we had a customer who said, what do you recommend? The way for weighted blankets to put the right amount of pressure onto someone that they need in order to create serotonin or melatonin is by body weight. So the first thing, if someone wants to order a sensory blanket, says, what do you recommend? You have to look at the weight of the population you're serving. And it's typically around 10%. So if you have adults that are between 100 and 150 pounds, you want to recommend a 15-pound blanket. From a marketing perspective, I think that'd be a great thing to put in our catalog as a little guide. Or it could be a separate cut sheet, or it could be an information piece on our website. From a sales perspective, or rather for you and Melissa, from a product branding perspective, I would love to see weighted slippers in our catalog. Because weighted slippers are a fabulous thing for kids when they take their shoes off to get to school. Because the schools all say in the winter, take your boots off and put your shoes on. And in the nursing home, people are usually in socks or slippers. And sometimes that weight on the feet can be really, really instrumental in helping to level this playing field. So new product would be great. In terms of a sales tool with the weighted blankets, they are such a good tool for all the A's and all the S's and all the rounds in between, that I would honestly bet the farm that there is not a school in Canada that doesn't have at least one child with autism. And if we're not doing business with that school, this is now the gateway. To say, if you are working with a child with autism who may be hyper and hard to settle and won't sit at reading time and need ones to one, your school could really benefit from a weighted product. It doesn't have to be a weighted blanket. It could be something on the lap. It could be a weighted vest. But it's a very affordable tool, and that one tool opens the gateway into all the other sensory stuff. From a saleability piece, I think the first thing is to look at are your clients, you know, hyper or hypo? I don't expect sales and customer service to do all this. But basically the thing someone asks is to ask, what weight? Is it children? Is it adults? Is it larger adults? The other piece with the weighted element is it doesn't necessarily have to be a weighted blanket. So you can offer the variety. I would often say to a client, I think a great piece to start with is the weighted blanket. But if you have a population in wheelchairs, it is very difficult to get them out of their wheelchair so that a blanket can cover enough of that sensory organ to make a difference. In that case, I would say get a weighted blanket, but you're also going to want a weighted lap pad or weighted slippers, something of that nature. And that's the best bang for your buck. In terms of an upsell, I would never sell one of these without suggesting a cover, and I'm pretty sure we have the blanket covers. From new product perspective, maybe it's a disposable cover because the schools don't have the ability to launder them, the nursing homes do. So we might look at something disposable. The reason I suggest that is with a blanket, typically when you best use the blanket, you're in a laying position. When you're relaxed and when your sensory stimulation is balanced, as silly as this sounds, when you're so relaxed, your brain relaxes, you tend to do two things. And this is in the population of people who are disabled. They will tend to drool and they will also tend to urinate because you're relaxed. And so the body functioning starts happening. So for our children with disability that are diapered, you want to make sure you have a cover in case it gets soiled and or drool on. But to me, that's a great upsell. And that's also a fabulous service, and it increases the longevity of the product. Really, from a telesales perspective, I would say if someone calls and wants to order a blanket, those are great questions to ask, so we make sure we get the right thing and make sure that it's used properly. I would also say anytime a school or nursing home calls us to order anything, whether it's snacks or puzzles or Play-Doh, we can say to them, well, do you have a population in your home with autism or Alzheimer's? Have you ever thought of weighted blankets? Like, it's such an easy sell. The second piece, and I will say this to the guys at West or the guys in Montreal and Quebec, and for our sales team here in Ontario, I'm also really happy to put together a 5-minute thing on this, that if it's a phone call with a school or home, or a visit with a school board, to do a half an hour on the benefits of sensory blankets is great. Because what people typically do is they think, oh, I'm gonna make little Billy warm and cozy, and that's gonna settle him down. Well, if little Billy is hyperactive, that might not work. So we tend to think of these as calming and warm and cozy. They're not. They do affect the brain chemistry in terms of creating serotonin and melatonin. And they can affect, they have a residual effect on behavior. Fair enough? Mm-hmm. 10 minutes in a nutshell, weighted blankets.